Hi guys, thanks for tuning in to another video on ForgottenWeapons.com. I'm Ian McCollum and I am here today filming on Malta, courtesy of the Association of Maltese Arms Collectors and Shooters. And one of the things we have to take a look at is not an MP38. This is actually one of Dittrich's BD-38 semi-automatic open bolt new production copies of the MP38. These are made in Germany. Dittrich has a reputation for making really, really nice, really, really expensive copies of German World War II firearms. So here in the US, the one we're most familiar with is the his Sturmgewehr copies. They came in through PTR as the PTR 44. And really, actually, those developed quite a poor reputation. They had some heat treat and material specification problems and tended to break parts. However, the BD-38 has a much better reputation. Now, this is a gun that we can't get in the United States because it is a semi-automatic open bolt firearm. And under German law, because this fires in semi-auto, it's a semi-auto firearm and can be manufactured and produced, etc., and owned, etc. In the US, because it fires from an open bolt, it's considered easily convertible into a machine gun and thus prohibited from new manufacture. So we can't get these. It was pretty cool to find one here on Malta where they can be legally owned and give it a try. So on the outside, it seems like a really nicely made gun. They have copied, as far as I can tell, basically everything down to some pretty minute details from the original MP38s, including the weight. This is quite a heavy gun. The original MP38 doesn't have a stamped receiver. It looks like it should because it's tubular, but it is actually a milled from a block of steel, or probably a bar, a round bar of steel receiver. Anyway, we have an original MP38 magazine with the flat sides, and then later on, of course, they changed that to add a couple of ribs to help with reliability issues. But let's see how this thing actually shoots. By the way, it has the correct amount of original stock wobble in it. Well, that's not good. Let's try the other magazine. With the exception of not going full auto, that's really exactly what an MP38 or 40 feels like. That's pretty cool. So I think the BD-38 here really exemplifies some of the long-standing issues with manufacturing reproductions of historic firearms. They tend to be very expensive to do because in order to sell reasonably well, people tend to have pretty high expectations of quality and accuracy. And where guns like these were originally manufactured by the tens of thousands, for the modern reproduction market, you're looking at, if you're lucky, tens of hundreds of guns to actually sell. And so the prices are much higher than most people would expect. There is a group of people who recognize the amount of work that has to go into making something like this, and they're willing to pay appropriately for it. But that tends to always be a smaller group than anybody estimates, either the people manufacturing the guns or people who are wondering why more of this sort of thing doesn't get made. For those of you who are in places where an open bolt semi-auto is legal to own, this is a cool way to get your hands on something that looks and functions like an MP38, where original MP38s are going to be substantially more expensive, presumably, and harder to find. and perhaps harder to actually take out and shoot, depending on the laws in the country where you are. But for those who want it, it's a pretty cool option. And anyway, big thanks to the Maltese Shooter and Collector Association for bringing me out to the range and letting me try out their BD-38 and bring it to you guys. Thanks for watching.